I have this habit. I'm not doing this to show off with the film, but I just reach up and say, I talk to the statue because I believe the spirit of what it represents. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for this day. Thank you for your love and your guidance. In Christ, Lord God, Jehovah, the Almighty, the All in All. That, oh, my wish on this planet now, at the age I'm at, I can very quickly say, you'll love this. I pray, Lord, as soon as possible, for the convenience of your using us, true, that we may all be one in Christ.
Nice. Here we go. The bass line I'm using here, this little bass, 1927, Papa Jimmy Yancey. He was an old-time boogie-woogie pianist. He was the actual inspiration to Ammons, my teacher. Nice.
I was at the Shipwreck Lounge, and that's where I had my claim to fame. People had come from all over just to come and catch my maddening shows. Preacher Jack with his Budweiser bottle preaching the word of God and, you know, acting like a madman. Round of Records had signed me in 1979 and started traveling.
They said, look at this. This guy looks like a Jerry Lee Lewis kind of a guy. We got to hear him. He's wild in person as he is in these photographs. Around 1980, I think it was, Dolly Parton made her musicians on their break listen to me. And she said, ooh, he sounds like Jerry Lee. Come down here, we'll get him some bookings. Rainbows of fire, ice running through my veins. The golden love and I did on occasion get fired. It was during my drinking days. I was playing sloppy, talking too much anyway, as I do anyway. I'm not insulted by that. People say, shut up and play the piano. You're tormenting us, preacher. I said, okay. But I have this message I'd like to share with you. You know, Judah Ben-Hur, Judah Ben-Hur, ride that chariot, Judah Ben-Hur, ride it for Israel and Jerusalem, Salem, Salem, Jerusalem, Shalom. I told people I didn't have time to take a pause. Mm-hmm. I said, I just want that. I want that little baby Budweiser. Oh, I'm feeling good. I'm okay. You're obnoxious. Get out of here. Okay.
When you know culture, baby, you know what I'm doing. This is not. This is the real American music.
It was like an idiot out of control. It was like it had its humorous moments, and then it had its disgusting moments. Not being a recording artist with a hit record, I had the respect of the people who have had hit records, and they say, oh, Preacher Jack. And they usually say nice things about me. So I've gained their love and respect, and that is for the efforts of my music, for what I do. And I, you know, even though my mom said I haven't taken it to the crescendo, I got lazy and I enjoyed being at a certain level. I really never desired to be big and famous. It's too much of a headache and responsibility. Being obsessive and compulsive by nature has helped me immensely with my driving of piano chords and the music. It's really helped me. But being that way, facing other issues, I might have weakened without going into great detail, one of the powerful drawing energy from me, if I concentrate on it, it's gotten me into trouble that I allowed my compulsive nature to pursue things that weren't good. The saddest part of sexual addiction is sexual addiction, if you're going to cater to that and it's wrong, it's not, it's lust, it's not love, It's not a thing that is holy at all. It's abusing the sexual energy. And I said, no wonder I yell at people, because they're loving me. I don't feel worthy of the love. And when I was drinking, I drank with a hate for myself on that side of the fence. And it was almost to the form, without sounding like a coward, where I, at one point, I wanted to just get rid of myself. But there's a lot of people that still love me as a person, and as long as I'm not pursuing anything similar and being that kind of a person, an animal, just, you know, your primal drives, but you're abusing them. Knowing the weakness is a takeover, I lean heavily on the spirit and love of Christ, because I feel the perfection there. Christ loves us, not lusts us. So I say, in self-mockery, I say, Lord, here you are loving me and I'm lusting the world. This isn't good at all. This isn't gonna work. And I realize that. So you're only gonna tolerate that for so long. I become almost, and my wife admitted this, she said, you've almost had to become a spiritual fanatic and just going wild. It enhances my love for music because it fills that gap with real love.
Well, the day is beautiful though. Even though the wind's a little cool, this is one of our better days.
My desire in life now is to be a better version of myself. Just be the best John I can be as just me. So God is pleased with me and I feel like I'm clean. I'm admitting to my sins and I'm trying to balance them and get rid of them.
And the interesting point is he's wearing the crown of glory. So his crucifixion is symbolic in the pose. But if you look at his head, it's the crown of glory. In other words, I'm back. I've been crucified, dead and buried, and I'm back.
Okay, I'll do this for you. Ready? I might be a little off key, but you won't mind. The spirit will be there for you. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, special sacred scenes unfold. Loving mother, loving father, special memories of home. Special memories.